All right, so first and foremost, we have the limit set here. The other thing we can go ahead and do is for now, I mean, the easiest we can do is just a condition here. So we could say data sort by, and in this case, popular. We want to order by views, otherwise, we want to order by sort by. And in this case, it's going to be created at or updated at in descending order. And for now, we can essentially go ahead and set articles to just null a first instantiator here, or we could just essentially leave it. But I think, personally speaking, the best way to approach this would be to say articles, article query, and then we will essentially just set this here. We could also just remove it here actually. So if we go in here, we need to go ahead and get rid of this now. I think we can now go ahead and just say articles. No, for now, I'll see if that works. So if we go in now, we should hopefully see a difference. We can also go ahead and add in a heading here. Data heading. And let's go ahead and die dump on articles. In this case now, the first one we have here is test one because we're ordering in this case by article block. But let's check if we actually reach in here. We should be reaching in here based on what we're seeing. So let's go ahead and say data, and in this case, sort by, and let's go ahead and make sure we have that in both of these conditions. So this is for the popular and this is for the data here. So let's see what we get. You're getting popular. Perfect. So if I was going to go ahead into our database, into wire content here, into the blocks, we could even do this inside the website here. So if you do wire content test admin, we can go ahead in here into articles. We can see what happens inside our pages article block here. Go ahead and edit it. Let's go ahead and change this to sort by created, updated that even actually. See what that looks like. So let's see if this breaks the application when we are using this one in here. And I don't think we need to instantiate it there. So let's go and leave that. Okay, perfect. So we're getting a collection here. So that's great. So in here we now have the test here, which is the one that was updated at the 28, and then we have another one in here where we updated that at the 28, but we updated this one last. So if we go ahead now, we go in and edit an article here. We're gonna go ahead and edit article 3. We should hopefully see a different result. If you go down here, it does look like it's not sorting. Or it didn't update the updated add. Okay, let's go ahead and just update the article instead and see what happens there. So we go into test 3 and we set this to now. We have test 3, perfect. So now it's sorting by the correct category here, which is even more ideal. So for now, what we can go ahead and do inside here, we can get into the home page. And then here we have this block here, so we can go ahead and essentially copy this block. And instead of saying this articles, we're going to have to just say articles. There we go. So now we're essentially able to sort these by different levels. Yes, this is, in this case, Article 3. We need to fix this data, how it's stored in the database, but that's fine. And we also have Article 2 and 1. And we have this heading here, but first and foremost, let's make sure that the text for non-dark mode is text gray 900. And let's go ahead and make sure as well that we add that into here. Perfect. And then let's go ahead and pass in another prop here, which is going to be the heading. And let's go ahead and add in the heading here. There we go. So now we can control the heading. We can control this all by created ad, updated ad, or the most popular one. And then we can also go ahead in here and have paragraph, perhaps even just under here. And then we can have, in this case, we have article, and we can pass through the description. Show load more button we can work on a bit later. And if we go into our article.blade.php, we can go ahead and essentially copy this here. So let's go ahead and make sure we do that. And in this case, we have this article block here where we have text output here. So we also want to go ahead and make sure that this exists. But first and foremost, let's just go ahead and make sure we include the property. And we could go ahead and just check if description is set. And we need to go ahead and just see if we can die down bonus so we can see the value. So we need to go ahead and say DIDOM description tip tap converter as text description count. So in this case, we at least now get the text here. So we can go ahead and say if this is set. Perfect. All right, that's all for this video. Thank you very much for watching it. Please hit the like, subscribe button.